Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. We continue with Gitagovinda. 10th video, Canto 5.1. In the history of Vaishnavism, the Bhagavad Puran exercised a profound influence on the development of the bhakti cult in medieval India. The eternal sports of the Lord in an imaginary Vrindavan are regarded by his devotees as a stepping stone for the realization of Godhead. The supreme message of the Bhagavat is passionate love for the beloved, which transforms bare sex impulses into ecstatic religious fervor. Gitagovinda is a continuation of the same. Vaishnavism existed in Bengal before Jayadev's time, but there is no doubt that it is the passionate songs of Jayadev that we find for the first time a new trend in the growth of Vaishnavism. It is doubtful whether Jayadev had anything of the nature in mind, for he is primarily a poet and not a doctrinaire. He has woven into his songs an eroticism of fascinating beauty, imageries which make the poems throb with passion, and above all, world music which flows like a murmuring brook gushing in a verdant forest. This is the way Gitagovinda has been described by the author in Lalit Kala series portfolio number 15 on Gitagovinda. Jayadev had the genius to create a novel form of literature which has been regarded by the later generations as a thing of enduring beauty. Within a century after his death, Jayadev's fame spread all over India, and the songs of Gitagovinda were sung and danced in the temples and to gatherings of the Vaishnavas both in the south and north. In the segment I am taking up today, Krishna sends a message to Radha, describing her, his own longing to meet her. In the earlier videos, we had seen how Radha's messenger is cajoling Krishna to go to her. Now Krishna says, "Please come to me, Radha. I am suffering, I am pining for you." The poet writes, "Tav virahe vanamali sakhi siddhati." Oh my dear friend, Krishna, who wears garlands of wild flowers, suffers because he is separated from you. You are not the only one to suffer. He too is suffering. He says, "I am waiting in this bower, Sakhi. Go and use your good offices. Use sweet words. Invite Radha on my behalf to come over. I am willing to be with her. I am waiting for her. I'll give up all bakwas. I won't look at others." Now approaching Radha, the poet writes, the Sakhi said, "The breeze from the Malaya mountains excites a kama. Flowers bloom and invigorate the separated lovers with their scents and looks. During Vasant, in your absence, Krishna suffers and longs for you. Even the cool rays of the moon burn Krishna in your absence, Radha. He is no longer playful. It is as if he is approaching death. Severely injured by Kama's arrows, your love laments his fate. Krishna no longer enjoys the humming of the Brahmaras. He shuts his ears to their music. Thinking of you, upset, he spends whole nights weeping. Thinking of you again, Krishna has given up his comfortable home and wanders in the forest. He lies bare on earth chanting your name all the time. When the koels coo in the spring, an upset Krishna wanders directionless chanting your names. It's a remarkable image. He wanders directionless, goes here, there, chanting Radha, Radha, Radha. The bystanders make fun of him and laugh at his antics. It's the description more of a maniac, a mad person. Hurt by their comments, he ticks them off, asking, "Why do you harass me? I have suffered no end. She doesn't care for me. She doesn't come to me. She is sitting far away." We have included in this video a painting where the images are juxtaposed. Radha is sitting in one corner, Krishna in the other of the forest. When Krishna listens to the bird song, my friend, early morning, he is reminded of your sweet musical voice, remembering your moments of love making, shedding coyness. Krishna sings of pleasure mutually derived by both of you. Krishna listens attentively if anyone mentions the Radha month, Chaitra. He loves to hear your name being spoken. He starts chanting Radha, Radha, Radha the moment he hears your name. He sings of none else, my friend. Says the poet Jayadev, listening to this blessed narrative of Krishna's fondness for Radha and of his consequent suffering, a devotee's heart will open to Krishna bhakti for sure. Well, it did, and it continues to be so. We stop today. We meet again, maybe tomorrow or next week, with the next part of this canto, which is very touching. Thank you for visiting this site and listening to me.